peeped into the basket so that he saw one egg left in the basket.
Exactly right. Yeah, that is an answer. So the last person took the basket with the last egg that is still inside. This is actually, you know, we need to think something differently, right? This is a very simple thing. We need to think differently. This is what is also called as lateral thinking. Now we know about lateral thinking. I know that I can keep on giving a number of examples here, but how to stimulate the individual creativity for all of us, right? For a lateral thinking, right? And then we'll get into a few more problems and solutions. So this is the difference between a linear thinking and lateral thinking. Linear thinking actually follows a defined path, right? Say my value is to save the old lady, I will talk about the old lady. My value is to go with my friend, right? I will go with her. So this is actually pursuing your direction in a defined path is called as linear thinking. Whereas a lateral thinking, it jumps to new paths, right? And please understand, this is very important. The difference between a linear thinking and lateral thinking is, as you move towards getting a new technology, right? Particularly for an MCS students, right? Today we are talking about the Java. I mean, yesterday we talked about Java, and today we are talking about the Python, right? Tomorrow, who knows, right? Something else may come, right? Machine learning, we are talking about it, artificial intelligence, right? Even now blockchain, big data, so many things are on our way, right? So instead of going in a defined path, we are always going towards a new or hybrid path, right? I'm not saying that don't follow the old technology or old path. It's very important. That's a stepping stone. But soon, we need to quickly migrate from the linear thinking towards the lateral thinking as a student. Now, first thing is suspending the judgment. I'm sure that most of you might have talked about, you know, first immediately you'll fix your solution, okay? Yeah, I'm there. I'm going to help the old lady. Yes, old lady. You will not even think after that, actually, right? So rather, we need to suspend the judgment actually moving towards the solution. Just think through what are the different ways. That is the first step to move towards the lateral thinking. Next one is the dismantling or fractionalization of the problem into parts. This is so simple, two problems we told. But we talked about it, but whenever a big problem is given, so right, how will you eat an elephant? People say, how can I eat an elephant? But yes, you can cut into pieces and put it in the fridge. You can eat it, right? So simple solution. So this is how you need to, whenever there is a big problem, right, in your professional life or in your career, in your personal life also, just try to fractionalization of the problem into parts. That is another thing. And of course, you might be knowing about this metaphor. This is an easiest way to think, move towards lateral thinking, right? People say that, you know, the economy is melting. Stock market is melting. Okay, there's nothing called melting, right? And I am struck. This is the most of the people nowadays talking about. I am struck with my life. There is nothing. No, you cannot struck with your life. No, life will keep on going, right? So for all those things, we are using a metaphor, right? But we can use a metaphor for the simulating the individual creativity. For example, right? You can all associate yourself. Just think of the animal which resembles you. Maybe it can lion, it can be a tiger. For me, it is an eagle. Okay, maybe I'll talk about it later. Why eagle and all. So whenever you have a metaphor for you, you can, whenever you are getting into some problem, right, you can easily associate what the metaphor will do. Thereby, you can find a solutions. Nowadays, even for business problem, right, for every organization also, we started identifying the metaphor. For example, some organization can be associated with the white lotus. So whatever the white lotus will do, right? And accordingly, whenever you are facing a problem, it's another way to find a lateral thinking and lateral solution. That is called as metaphor. Another one is, yes, next level to the metaphor is analogy. Of course, analogy helpful for a metaphor also. You might be knowing, right, while you're finding an atom, I don't know how many of you think through this actually. The atom also, we have a proton, neutron, nuclear, all those things, right? That is also similar to our solar system. Actually, the person, right, Niels Bohr, while you're actually modeling the atom, he tried to compare it with the solar system, right? Thereby, he was able to study more about the atom. This is also actually called as a lateral thinking.